And the best example I could think of that, there was a TGI Fridays a couple miles from my house. And so quite often I'd stop in there for a nightcap on the way home from work or whatever. Okay. And I got to know this one female bartender, and she was just delightful, very sharp. She was working her way through college, being a bartender with the TGI Fridays. And that restaurant happened to be in an area where they had lots of medical offices, a hospital, and everything else. And so reps for drug companies would quite often bring their clients there for lunch. And she got to know a lot of these reps and talking about what they do and everything else. She decided that's what she wanted to do after graduation from school. And about 2 months before she was going to graduate, the local regional manager for all these sales reps was in the restaurant. So she talked to him and talked about her interest in becoming a bartender. Now, I'm hearing the story from him. I talked to him about 6 months later. So I'm not hearing this from her, I'm hearing this from him. And he told her, he said, "I'm sorry, we have a policy. We only hire people with at least 3 years of sales experience." And she says, "I've had 5 years of sales experience." He says, "Well, where?" "Right here." He said, "Well, that doesn't count." She said, "Ask me any question." This is the guy's telling me. So I asked her, you know, "How do you upsell a person? How do you handle a disgruntled customer? How do you do this?" He says, she nailed every answer. And she translated her TGI Fridays experience into her next venture life. And within 6 months, she was his top producer.
Wow.
That was pretty cool. I really enjoyed working with that group.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
Good.
We had one here, don't we, in Pensacola?
We had one, but they closed it.
Oh, they did close it. Yeah. I haven't seen one at some point. Yeah. Oh,
I'm not sure where the closest one is now. Okay.
Yeah. But they're in airports and things. I know that he used to always have a floor. Yeah. Well, thank you very much, Jim. That's great. And then he forgot that he did not mention he's the treasurer of the Audubon Society.
Right.
And the crew of reps.
Good for you.
So that's awesome.
I call myself a recovering accountant.
Well, that's great. Thank you so much for sharing. Okay, and we have Teresa Markham. We are so excited that she has agreed to run for secretary again. She's been doing an amazing job. Is there anything you want to share or say? But we are very, very grateful for all.
Oh yeah, I was in the restaurant business for almost 20 years.
Wow.
I waited tables. I wouldn't wait tables here in Pensacola. Southern California. I started in catering down at Edgewater.
Okay.
In Fort Walton, is it? Anyway, I waited New York City. Key West, Isla Mirada, and Coconut Grove in Miami. I waited tables. Like I said, Southern California, New York City. That was fun. Yeah. So there's a lot of life learning experiences from waiting tables.
And that's why you're so versatile and so good. See, she's got that same background.
Yeah.
Well, that's great, Therese. Well, thank you. No. And Therese is so good about posting on social media and sharing and getting the word out there. And wonderful to have you. Okay, and then for treasurer, we have Luella Kahn. And do you want to just tell a little bit about yourself, Luella?
Okay. I'm married to Rusty Kahn here, and I'm retired from the legal field. Worked as a legal assistant at Shell Fleming Davis and Mingy for 35 years total. And then at one point, I left there to be Rusty's bookkeeper when he went into business for himself. So I know a little bit about things are supposed to balance, you know, but I'm not an accountant, you know, by any means. Okay. And I've lived here since 1975, and both my children went through the schools here, and now our grandchildren are going through the schools here. And we just love it here, and I'm happy to be a part of this society and hope that we can grow it and to fulfill the wishes set forth by our be Louise Benson in her will when she willed this property, her home, and money to the society and the community. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Yvonne.
I did bookkeeping too, and retail, and medical transcription. Okay, I'm done.
I think for a lot of us, that's, you know, I've got a very varied background myself. But that's kind of how Luella and I met. We do go to the same church, but when Luella is the one where she worked, that was the attorney that had probated the will. And at that point, we were trying to get a copy of the will, and Luella had the copy of the will. So that's sort of what started us, you know, and then Rusty got involved, and that was a blessing, and so.
The will was sent to the Historical Society. It's not like I got it.
No.
Surreptitiously or something, but it's, that was the previous board.
Yeah, and I eventually did find a copy of it.
Did you? Good.
But when I first started, I didn't know anything. When Trish Briska asked me, well, let's see, am I the next one to talk?
Yes, you have to tell us about yourself.
Yes, so, I mean, like, well, we moved here as a family. You heard our whole thing last month in 58, but I left in 64. So I lived here for 6 years, you know, in my teen years. And, but then I met and married a Navy guy who was from New Jersey. So I ended up in New Jersey and was there for 30 years. And unfortunately went through that divorce, but met and married Dave, who was from Pittsburgh and took a job in Jersey. So I met him in Jersey, so that was a blessing. And we'll be married 37 years next month.
Wow, good deal.
Yeah, so not next month, August. But but I was in banking 20 years, and I did Mary Kay part-time off and on, but then I was a full-time Mary Kay director for 20 years. And I did say I was in sales off and on, and
you got the car, didn't you?
Yeah, I had earned nine cars.
Nine?
Yeah. Three were Grand Ams and six were Grand Prix, and the last Grand Prix we bought out of the lease. I never got the Cadillac because I was always doing I did Mary Kay more part-time than you. To win that Cadillac, you gotta be doing it 100%, full speed ahead, you know. I was the director of Safe Harbor Medical Pregnancy Center, part of that when I was a director, and always doing other things along with my Mary Kay. But that was the blessing of doing Mary Kay. You could do, if it was your own business, you could do other things.
Were they all pink, Barbara?
No.
The cars?
The Cadillac is the pink one. But one time, they did let you get a pink Grand Prix, and I did have a pink Grand Prix. And when I was turning that back in, and again, you could buy it out of the lease, it was a good deal. My mother wanted a car, and she needed a car, and she bought the Grand Prix. So mother had so much fun driving that pink Grand Prix. Because she was one of my best Mary Kay consultants. She was a true entrepreneur, because she had the Guys and Dolls department store here when they lived here in the 50s and 60s. But she just loved sales and was a really good salesperson. And so, I checked the corporate bylaws and all. I had to go through all just to see if I could run one more time. And yes, this is the last year I can run, though. You can serve 2 3-year terms in the same office, but that's it. So this is my last year as president. And again, it's been a labor of love. I don't mind doing it, but we need, you know, as Luella said, we need more new members, and we need new blood. And I really think it's going to happen this year. So we're going to think positive, and we're going to do things that are going to, you know, just help to come along. And then we have on the slate tonight, Ann Livingston is going to be is on the slate as a new board member. And Ann, tell them a little bit about you.
Okay, I was in accounting too at Hewlett Packard on the West Coast, and my husband was in the Navy on the West Coast, California and Washington State, and then he had gone through AOCS here a long time ago, and then we came back in 91 just because we liked the area, like so many people. And I had my own business for a while. It sold checks and business forms, business to business. And I used to be on the Historical Society board a long time ago with Trish.
I know, I would see your name in all the records.
Yeah, and it'd be interesting to be back.
Yes. Well, we're glad to have you back. And that's because you kind of retired from your business part, right?
Yeah, I sold the business.
Yeah, and I'm so excited to have you coming back on because we do belong to the Chamber of Commerce. And I'm the one that usually attends the breakfast, but you know, you can attend on behalf of that. And everybody knows you there and everything. So that'll be good though. See, people will be like, oh, Ann's, you know what I mean? It's just getting the word out there. And then Martha Grenenstahl is remaining. I don't know why she's not here tonight. If she texted me since I left the house, I didn't check my phone. And Kristen Marks is remaining. So they're board members at large. So they're not holding an office, but they're board members.
Kristen Parrish,
what did I say?
Marks.
Oh, you know.
We got someone new?
Kind of.
No.
Okay.
No. She's an attorney. But I don't know that many Kristens, so it's like my mind goes there. And unfortunately, Diane is going to step down from the board. And Diane, we have so appreciated your service on the board. She started out as treasurer and then was a board member at large and then came back as treasurer last year because Carolyn Pfeiffer had passed away and then Ken, you know, was taking it over and then he had stuff. Well, it's been a challenge and we're going to pray for Luella that she stays strong and healthy and well.
Nothing happens.
But Diane, thank you so much for your service. And Diane's going to still
thank you, Diane.
Yes. She's going to still be a member and a supporter. She's always been an encourager to me, and I'm sure she'll continue to do that. So I appreciate that. So okay. So that is I think I went through the whole slate. So now, if anybody, we can take nominations from the floor. So if anybody wants to run for anything, I'm just assuming nobody else is chomping at the bit to get to take one of these positions. Am I right? Are there any nominations from the floor? All right, so then, so that's the slate. And so if everyone's in favor, I guess maybe raise your hand. And if anybody, and then I'll do opposed afterwards. So if you're in favor, just raise your hand.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, it's unanimous. So
are you voting
thank you so
fast?
Much. And, now we need
trying
a picture.
To get pictures.
We do need a photograph. Betty will have mine. She'll be on my case if I don't have a photograph. Oh, are you going to take it on that? Oh, okay, but you have to be
want
in
me to ask,
let's take one quick, so we don't forget. Okay,
do
so
now?
The new board, would step forward, we'll get a picture.
The new board members.
You have to take it off of this. You have to take it off the board to take the photo.
Oh, okay.
You have to take